I never left the world of Dune. In fact, I think Denis thought I was quite mad because I kept writing after we finished the movie. But because I knew the story, I knew the book, I knew it was coming our way. And in fact, one of the main themes in this movie was written at the end of the first movie. I was standing up at Warner Brothers, and Denis came up to me, and we were just talking, and he very quietly said, "Have you ever read a book called Dune?" And I sort of, I became one of those little dogs that goes a little wild, right? I think I frightened him. Denis is an extraordinary human being, first and foremost, and secondly, an extraordinary director. And then he managed to do some magic tricks. You know, the internal monologue I was talking about that is so uncinematic. He managed to figure out how to go and give you that side of the story without doing voiceover and stuff like that. He is an amazing filmmaker. He's an amazing... He made it into a film as opposed to a talking book. I never understood why a film set on some strange planet in the future should use your normal romantic middle European orchestra. You know, why am I suddenly hearing violins? You know, this all seems to be wrong. So we started building instruments. And we started designing instruments. People love criticizing this town about its brutality and about its callousness. You know, I don't think I've ever worked with anybody who is quite as considered as a human being as Denis. You know, and I think everybody. You know, when this room is full, you know, when full of musicians and full of sound designers and full of, you know, everything that, you know, everything we're throwing at it, and, you know, and Denis is in this room, I know that everybody in this room would do anything for him, you know, because in a funny way, I know he would do anything for us, you know. So it's, you asked me, what was it like to come from the first movie to the second movie? Well, it was coming back to the family. At the end of the day, I think, I mean, look, I know, I've done this for 47 years, this movie thing, writing music for movies, and the thing that never has changed is I always write for the people that are going to go and come and see this movie. I always try to do them justice. I try not to take, you know, be cheap about things. I remember Ridley Scott saying to me once, sentimentality is secondhand emotion. I always thought that was really good. So if you write, for instance, an emotional theme, make it an emotional theme, don't make it a sentimental theme, you know. Give it a bit of class. This collaborative process whereby, yes, I write the music. I write the music, but that's only a fraction of what we're doing. You know, I see it much more as a directorial role. You know, if you think about what a director does, I mean, especially somebody like Denis, who writes as well, you know, sits in the cutting room, obviously knows how to edit, obviously knows his cameras, obviously knows his light, obviously knows how to persuade his actors. So many things, you know, are going on, and I, at a certain point when we're all in this room and we're talking about music, you know, my musicians, my technicians become my actors. I'd love to talk to you about Pedro because here's the thing, you know, we were talking about super duper computers and super duper science and synthesizers, and you look around this room and it's full of machines, etc. And then comes in Pedro, and he plays you something beautiful. And I'm going, what's this instrument? He goes, oh, I went to the plumbers. It's PVC. It's PVC piping that they actually use in toilets. And I've built this instrument out of it. And this happens all the time. Denis was very nervous showing this film because it was very unfinished. He didn't know me. And I started to play, and he just said, but that's what I heard all along. And we never needed, we've said a lot of things since then, but in a funny way, that was probably the most important statement we made to each other. I, in the language of music, and he in just going, yeah, that's what I imagined. I like them to hear the music, but I would like them to not be that aware of it. I would like them to be aware of the whole, the complete experience. Because the first time Denis showed me the film, actually, I kept having this experience where something new and original was happening. And I'm going, oh, that's pretty great. And then 2 minutes later, something new and original was happening. And he kept upping the ante. To Denis and me, somehow, this book, you know, and we're not talking about Kafka, Goethe, Shakespeare, Chaucer, James Joyce. We're not talking about, you know, the canon of great world literature. We're talking about something completely different. We're talking about something that got under our skin when we were teenagers. And when we were working on it, it took us back to that time, and it took us back to the purity of that time. And I think, look, we live in an interesting world, which is turning. You've been outside today? It's turning more and more into the desert planet. But that's sort of even that is vaguely beside the point. It gripped us and never let us go.